Hello, my dear student. Welcome to my botany class of standard 7. In the previous class, I have explained about the structure of nucleus. Today, I am going to explain about the characteristics and function of plant tissues. So, today's topic's name is tissue. Every living body is made up of a cell or more than one cell. Depending on the number of cell, it is two types. Number one, unicellular organism, and number two, multicellular organism. The living body, which is made by one cell, is called unicellular organism, such as bacteria, yeast, Plasmodium, etc. Multicellular organism. The living body which is made by more than one cell is called multicellular organism, such as plants, animals. Here, for unicellular organism, all the physiological activities like nutrition, digestion, growth, reproduction are performed in one cell. But the multicellular organism has different organs for different metabolic activities. If all the cells of multicellular organism perform the same physiological functions at a time, then irregularities and anarchy would prevail in structural variations and physical activities of this organism. So, to ensure smooth life activities of multicellular organism, different type of cells form groups to perform the different type of activities. Normally, this group of cell is called tissue. So, the definition of tissue. When a group of cells originated from the same place and perform a common function, then those group of cells is called tissue. Plant body is composed of different type of tissues. Different type of tissues perform different specific functions. Depending on the division power, tissues are of two types. Number one, meristematic tissue. And number two, permanent tissue. So, what do you mean by meristematic tissue? The tissues which have the ability or power of divide are called meristematic tissues. It is present in growing part of plants. Here, growing parts mean apex of leaf, apex of stem, and apex of root. This is the picture of meristematic tissue. This tissue is capable of dividing. Small and isodiametric cells are found in this tissue. Very thin cell wall is present in meristematic tissue. Dense cytoplasm with prominent nucleus is present in this tissue. Vacuole is usually absent in meristematic tissue. Here, no intercellular space is present. This is the written description about the characteristics of meristematic tissues. Now, the functions of meristematic tissues. Meristematic tissue gives rise to new cells and tissues due to continuous division. It increases the height and girth of plants. Now, what do you mean by permanent tissue? The tissues which have no ability or power of divide are called permanent tissues. It is found in almost every part of plants. The characteristics of permanent tissues. This tissue is not capable of dividing. Cells are variable in size and shape. Thick cell wall is present. Thin cytoplasm with small nucleus is found in this tissue. Large vacuole is present in permanent tissue. Large and small intercellular spaces are present in this tissue. Now the function. Production and transport of food. Construct the body and strengthen the plant. This is the picture of permanent tissue. Here, large vacuole is present. Thin cytoplasm with small nucleus is present in permanent tissue. Here, large intercellular space is present. Here, cell wall is comparatively thick. Okay. So, in this class, we have talked about permanent tissue and meristematic tissue. I hope my lecture will be helpful to understand this topic. If you face any problem, you can contact with me. Thank you, everyone. Take care and stay safe.